Greetings, Matt fans. All right, so today we're going to talk about is concavity. That's what people in jail worry about, their cavities, the concavity. That's actually a lame joke. Okay. Basically, concavity is change in the slope of a line. Okay, remember the first derivative? I don't want to give too much away here yet. But the first derivative was the slope of the line. That's change in, right, like velocity, change in position over change in time. Well, this is change in slope over change in time. So maybe it's going to be the second derivative? Interesting. Well, let's actually make a quick graph here. I want to show you a little bit what concavity is. Okay, if I want to draw a picture here, and if I draw three different slopes. So this slope might be 5 over 1, and this might be 5 over 5, and this might be 1/5, right? So slope is getting, it's going from bigger, from 5 to 1 to 1/5. So this is getting, the slope is decreasing, which means it's concave down. Okay, and let's just do this one right below it here. So it's the same picture, but let's look at a couple different slopes here. One here, should be a tangent line there, even though it's not. There, and there. So this slope is, it's like saying up 1 over 5. So I'm kind of just making these slopes up here, but just to give you an idea. So it's up 1 over 5. This one's slope is 5 over 5. And this slope is 5 over 1. So what's going on is as you're going from left to right, you guys agree that your slope is increasing. It's going 1/5 to 5/5 is 1, which is 5. So 1/5 to 1 to 5. So this one is the slope is increasing. So this is called concave up. Okay, so if I write here the slope is increasing or decreasing, basically remember the slope is y prime. Okay, so concave up. Where f prime of x is increasing. And concave down is where f prime of x is decreasing. Okay? Because again, that's our slope. Our slope is y prime or f prime, right? Now I want you guys to think about the words increasing and decreasing. Right? So where a function f of x increases. You guys agree that the slope is greater than zero, right? If the function f increases, right? The original function increase is increasing, it's going up and up and up. That means the slope is positive. So let's go back to this guy right here. If f prime is increasing, right, f prime is increasing, what does that mean? That means the derivative of that, or the second derivative, is greater than zero. All right, is that's really, really important. Talking about the second derivative. So I can say it's concave up where f double prime of x is greater than zero, and concave down where f double prime of x is less than zero. All right, because again, we're talking about change of the slope. All right, so let me sketch a nice picture here for you guys. All right, so just looking at where it changes concavity, so let me change color here. This guy right here, this is concave down. Okay, because the slope is going from, remember, this is what we did before, an example, it's going from like, 5 to 1 to 1/5 to 0 to negative 1/5 to negative 1 to negative 5. And then what happens when it gets over to this point right here, this yellow point right here, right? It starts to go, we can even say this is negative 1/5 and negative 1. And or negative 5, negative 1, negative 1/5, 0, and then we start going up again here, 1/5, 1, 5. So at this point right here, this point right here, math fans, it's concave up, concave up. And then this point right here is concave down. Where it changes concavity, this is actually really, really important, this point right here. So it changes concavity. This is called an inflection point. Okay, so it's changing from concave up to concave down, or vice versa. Okay, a good way to remember this, math fans, at least the concave up and concave down, is, let me erase this just to give you a little idea. Okay. Okay, so this is concave up right here because it looks like up, right? U-P, up. And this one is concave down because it looks like D-O-W-N, down. I mean, just think of it, right? It's pointing, it's going down like this. That's concave down, and going up is concave up like this. Okay? Because you really need to be able to identify concavity. Now, here's the deal, math fans. Here's another thing here too. These inflection points, which I told you, these this point and this point are inflection points. It's the steepest part of the graph. Steepest slope. When I say steepest, I mean I'm talking about the slope. Okay, because let me delete this again and just draw it. Okay, so this is right here. That's the steepest part of the slope, whatever that slope is. And if you notice before that, right, it kind of goes like this, and here's the slopes of the tangent, right? This guy right here is the steepest, and then it starts to get less steep. And if you go before it starts, it's less steep. Okay, so the inflection point's at the steepest part of the slope. All right, let's do a couple examples here now. Here's your first example. Y is equal to x cubed minus 6x squared plus 9x. Okay, so we're going to take the first derivative. Y prime is equal to 3x squared minus 12x plus 9. So we set that equal to 0, factor out of 3, so that factors to x minus 3, x minus 1, so my critical points are 3 and 1. Okay, those are potential, those are candidates. So let's do a little investigation here. This is 1 and 3, and we're going to pick 0 and 2 and 4, right? And we're plugging that back into the derivative formula because we want the slopes on either side, and we get plus, minus, and plus, right? Positive, negative, positive, which means this guy here is a max, right? Take your hand and go up to down, and this guy here is a minimum. You're going from down back to up again. All right? So a couple things we can say. F of x has a relative max at x equals 1 since f prime of 1 equals 0 and f prime of x is changing from positive to negative at x equals 1. Sweet. Okay, and then we can say that same thing for our 3. F prime of x has a relative minimum at x equals 3 since f prime of 3 equals 0 and f prime of x is changing from negative to positive at x equals 3. All right, pretty easy. We can also say f of x is increasing between negative infinity and 1 un oops, union 3 and infinity since f prime of x is greater than 0. Right, the first derivative is greater than 0. And then we can say f of x is decreasing. That's between 1 and 3. Since f prime of x is less than 0. Okay, so this is all old stuff, right? Now let's check concavity. So let me kind of cursor down here a little bit. This is my first derivative, just to recall, just because it's not on the screen anymore. We get 3x squared minus 12x plus 9. So f double prime of x equals 6x minus 12. Okay? And we set that equal to 0, so 6x equals 12, x equals 2. That's a candidate for concavity, or for an inflection point. So we're going to pick a point on either side, 1 and 3. Okay, so if I plug this back into the derivative formula, it's very important. Okay, if I plug a 1 in there, I get negative. I plug a 3 in there, I get positive. So what this is saying, if I'm, first of all, 2, 2 is an inflection, or 2, if I plug this back into the original, I get 2 comma 2. Okay, and that is my inflection point. Okay, not bad. And see where it's plus here, math fans, and plus and minus? Okay, the minus means it's concave down. And the plus means it's concave up. It's really easy. So you're going to say it's concave up between 2 and infinity since f double prime of x is greater than 0. And concave down between negative infinity and 2 since f double prime of x is less than 0. There we go. The only thing I didn't mention here, going back here, I didn't give you guys the coordinates, right? So like this one, the one, it's 1 comma 4, and the minimum value was 3 comma 0. Plugging those values in. Okay, so that's one whole problem, finding all your critical points and concavity, increase, decrease, and etc. If I would, just with all that information, I can't display it all here because it's not enough room here, but if I would actually graph all that, just to kind of show you what it's going to look like, it's really easy once you have all that information. Okay, so let's make a quick sketch of all this with all the information you have. You guys agree that we have a relative max at 1 comma 4. So I'm just going to write max. I'm going to label some of the stuff. And I have a min at 3 comma 0. Okay, it's a relative min. And that's kind of what I have here. I can get one more point. My original equation is y is equal to x cubed minus 6x squared plus 9x. So in order to find my y-intercept, I set x equal to 0, and that happens to be my x-intercept as well. Okay, I want to plot my inflection point, which I think is a really important point. It's 2 comma 2, so it's right here. Now, the reason I it's nice to know concavity, remember it's concave up between 2 and infinity, and it's concave down between negative infinity and 2. This helps out a lot, math fans, because it's the deal. It's concave down between zero, negative infinity and 2. So, well, first of all, I'm going to cut through this here. Negative infinity and 2. Didn't you take your pen or pencil off the off your graph? And then it's concave up between 2 and infinity. So that means I'm going to go up. So up like that. That's what my graph looks like. Okay, it's kind of like when we graphed back in the day. Or let's just do sine, right? Sine would be here is one curve, and then here's another one, right? Otherwise, it looks kind of cavemanish. You kind of tend to go like this and tend to go like that, right? But it's a curve. Now you're looking at concavity. Okay? All right, let's do one more example here. I call this my Florida problem. So the Florida problem. Because it's such a hot problem. Okay, so f of x is equal to x to the fourth minus 4x cubed. And we actually did part of this yesterday, or past day, but I'm going to keep going here. We're going to just review a little bit. So f prime of x equals 4x cubed minus 12x squared. So set that equal to 0, and we can factor out a 4x squared, and we get x minus 3 equals 0. So x is 0 and x is 3. Okay, and if I do interval testing, so 0 and 3, negative 1, 1, and 4, our signs are negative, negative, positive. So that means that 0 is only does not work, and the 3 does work. So we wind up having 3 negative 27 is a relative minimum. Okay, there's got a lot of verbiage in here, but I'm just going to get through this. Okay, and then of course it is decreasing. And as opposed to saying from negative infinity to 3, because truly what's there's something going on right here. You can't say it's between negative 1 and 3. Okay, so it's decreasing between negative infinity and 0, union 0 and 3. And it's increasing between 3 and positive infinity. Okay? Pretty easy. Let's look at our second derivative to find out our inflection points. So f double prime of x is equal to 12x squared minus 24x. Okay, set that equal to 0. Factor out a 12x, and we get x minus 2. So we get x equals 0 and x equals 2. So two candidates. So we get negative 1, 1, and 3. And if we plug that back into the second derivative, because we're trying to find out what's going on, is it concave up, concave down, we wind up getting plus, minus, and plus. All right, now this is the deal, math fans. Something to kind of highlight here. See how this guy was a can or a possibility, right? A candidate, but because it was minus minus, it went basically decrease decrease, and then we go over to here, and that was one of our inflection points. So what this is called, because one of our inflection points is one of our possible critical values, we can say that this guy here is called a saddle point. Kind of a special name, saddle point. Okay? It still is an inflection point, but it's a special point. It's a saddle point because it's going from decreasing to decreasing as opposed to maybe back to increasing. So this coordinate is 0, 0, and that 2 is 2 comma negative 16. So remember, these are our inflection points. Okay. Let's move this down a little bit. It's concave up between negative infinity and 0, union 2 to infinity, and concave down between 0 and 2. All right. Okay, so let's graph this thing. Kind of plot a couple points here. First thing is you got a relative min at 3, negative 27. So relative min. You got an inflection point at 0, 0. So it's an inflection point. And you have an inflection point or at 2, negative 16. So roughly over here. Another inflection point. Okay, so let's look at our concavity. It's concave up between negative infinity and zero, because concavity really helps to graph these graphs, create the or graph the functions. Okay, so negative infinity to zero. Okay, so that would be, if I would keep going, it would be like a U shape. Okay, but now from zero to two, it's concave down. So watch. Concave down. Ooh. And then from that inflection point, you're going to hit that relative min, but it's concave up. So let's go back concave up. Okay, kind of a rough graph. Okay, but that's what it is. The concavity really helps you graph it. And again, why did I call that the Florida problem? Because it looks like Florida. It looks like Florida. Okay, so if I draw this, what are those? Those are the Florida Keys. Okay, very excited. Anyway, that's it for concavity math, fans. It really is not difficult, but just remember, concavity is change in slope. It's change, it's and the steepest value is where you are changing from concave up to concave down, which is your inflection point. Okay, that's it, math fans. Adios. Goodbye.